Hey folks, this is BestInSlot. Welcome back to our horror game experience thingamajiggy in Jurassic World Evolution 2. In part 1, we built the fairly calm main street with our brachiosaurus. Thank you to everyone who suggested the path was causing the problem, because the path was connected to the path over here and the brachiosauruses were walking on the path. The game kind of thought, well, that means they're going to trample all your people to death, even if that obviously wasn't going to be the case. I actually really like this main street. Obviously haven't done this area yet, but I appreciate all the suggestions. I like the idea of it being like a staging area. Maybe it's the construction of a new habitat that isn't quite in yet, something like that. But I will work on that before the next video when I've got a little bit more time. And obviously last video we built our broken out Dilo exhibit. The Dilos will make a reappearance later on. Not quite yet. It's like Chekhov's Dilophosaurus. You know, it needs a little bit of time. And then of course we had the Monolophosauruses over here on the other side, looking absolutely beautiful as per usual. So thank you for all the suggestions and comments. Keep coming with the ideas. There we go, that's good English speaking. Keep coming up with more ideas. Throw them in the comment section down below. Let me know what you think. But we're gonna work on the next habitat today. And it's kinda gonna be a meld of several ideas that you folks at home have been suggesting. There's a couple that I really liked, and I'm gonna try to integrate a few of them together. And let's get started. So the idea is first of all to fix this. Okay, bear with me. The idea is basically it's gonna be the start of the spooky town, right? The spooky town is now beginning. Oh, let me think about how I'm gonna do this actually. So the idea is there's been a bit of a catastrophe, things have fallen apart, and the path is going to be blocked off, right? On the left-hand side, so that's going to turn you over to the right. Let me think about this. Let me just start. I kind of had it planned, and now I've lost it. So you're going to curl. You're not going to go too far that way. And then the idea is you're going to want to walk this way. You're going to want to carry on walking, but maybe boxes have tumbled over, and there's a crane there, and maybe they were haphazardly trying to block an escaped dinosaur or something like that. So what you have to do is you have to turn the other way and head into a facility area to start your way out. And we're going to put some comp synapses in there. I don't want to put in a dinosaur that's actively going to murder everyone, but just something that tells you, you know what, you're dealing with carnivores here. The carnivores are loose, and if the compies have broken out, you know, what else has broken out? That's the general idea. So, and then we'll kind of obviously build up to more stuff after that as well. I really do want to do something with vehicles, but I like that as a finisher. I think having you're kind of trying to desperately escape in the tour vehicle or the gyrosphere or whatever as the finisher to the whole thing will look really cool. So I'm going to save that to the end. Need my sticks, of course. These are my favorite things in the entire game. I really love this as a decoration piece. Makes me very, very happy. Bam. It's a bit more, it's not quite what I actually meant to do, but that's neither here nor there. Nothing is ever quite what I mean to do, to be fair, so it's going to be a little tricky, isn't it? Yeah. It'll work. It'll work. No, it's not going to work. Go like that. Sure. Okay, so we'd have, let me block off this side. You can't see this, obviously, so let's just block that off. There's no electric concrete anymore. I think I've only just realized that there's no electric concrete fence anymore. Life is sad. I mean, life's always been sad, but now life is, like, super sad. So, this is your main path. So we need like a facility path, right? This is the path you're going to have to take. You're going to realize, you're going to walk along, you're going to see it's blocked, and then you're going to think to yourself, well, I guess I have to go this way. And that obviously is going to involve walking through a gate. So we're kind of doing two habitats in one here, I suppose, two parts of this, because you're going to walk through a gate and then you're going to walk through another gate. We're just going to do a little baby facility area here, so I'm not going to do too much on this. Like, it doesn't matter how long it is, it's more about the thickness. What can I say? You know what I mean. Anyways, moving on. So we need decorations. I think we're going to stack just quite a lot of these together. Again, the idea is for it to feel somewhat haphazard, not well planned. You know, it's just... Okay, this is over the top, admittedly. So it's a little bit too haphazard. Just enough that, you know, as a player, you would look at this and think, all right, I can't go this way. God, I love the noises. The crane noise. It's incredible. All the noises are really good. It's all got this lovely mechanical kind of sound to it. It sounds great. And maybe they've got like a little setup over here. Trying to monitor things. You know, a little encampment, like a little camp setup to try and go and catch the dinosaur over there. That you'd maybe get a glimpse of that, you know. Through the monstrosity that's going on here, maybe a few barriers hastily erected. Hasty. Never mind. Hasty erections are the best erect. Anyways. Yes. I don't know. It's a bit messy, but I think it's enough to suggest, you know what, you're not getting through here, son. You know, that's very much the point. This is not available to you. See how we feel. Right, this exhibit is much more work than I thought it was going to be. So what was contained in here? Velociraptors? I kind of like the idea of it being a raptor habitat. You could even do the suggestion that it was a Spinosaurus. It doesn't really matter. Whatever is in here is gone. Although it has to be something smaller, you'd think, because otherwise, you know, this is not a humongous exhibit, to say the least. It's got, like, quite light fencing. Maybe that's how we mix it up. Yeah, actually, I like that. That's how we make this feel different from that last habitat, because you go around here and, like, sure, the path is blocked, but it's when you notice this gap over here, or you notice the breakout, which you obviously will eventually, and that's when you get spooked. Okay, yeah, sure, Dilophosaurus has escaped, maybe that's something they can contain, but, you know, where's the Spinosaurus gone? That's a whole other kettle of fish. Plus it means I can use the skeleton. I built this curve area in on purpose, and I wanted to use it. You gotta kind of pretend with the design that these aren't here, that these boxes are not here at all. So, let's click the correct buttons. We can do it. I believe in me. There we go. Do 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 do. So, you know, you'd be walking around, you'd be looking at the Spinosaurus, it'd have like a display thing here, blah 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 blah. And we need a sign. Is there a Spinosaurus sign? I don't think there is there? Big carnivore. That's all you get to know. Big carnivore. And this can be Gallimimus, Parasaurolophus, Brachiosaurus, Triceratops. Triceratops? Sure. Okay. We'll obviously do some more decoration, but we have to do the thing we did last time again. I kind of committed to this idea now that I have concrete barriers, unfortunately, which means I have to once again build a billion concrete barriers, and I'm not going to subject you lovely people to that, so be back in a minute. Okay, there we go. I just think it really sells it as a park, as a zoo, as a tour, as everything, really. I just think having that barrier there really makes a big difference. It's kind of crazy. I was just thinking whilst I was doing this. So, when I first started this, the idea was to make this entirely modless. We are using one mod right now. All we're using is free build. That's the only mod I'm currently using in this playthrough. And of course, we've talked about the damage mod as well. I guess I want general perspectives on that, because the only reason I don't use more mods in this playthrough is because of you folks at home, because I feel like some people get a little bit annoyed by it, basically. That is the only reason. I'm not going to pretend otherwise. That is literally the only reason. I know some people prefer it when they can kind of build along with me, I guess, even people on console, which I understand, you know, that's totally legitimate. It's a thought process. My thing is, I guess, so we're using free build, so I guess people can't anyway, but there's a couple of other mods that I think would add a lot to this experience. One of them, of course, is fairly obviously going to be the, and again, I'm not like saying we're going to use this was suggested in the comment section actually last week, But there are Troodon mods out there. For those of you who've seen the Troodon from Jurassic Park, the game, there's Troodon mods out there that bring in that Troodon with the glowing eyes from Jurassic Park, the game. And obviously that is perfect for like a horror experience, right? Absolutely perfect for a horror experience. Because that's what it's from. It's from a horror game itself, you know, that horror moment in Jurassic Park, the game, where the Troodons pop out in the forest with those glowing eyes and it's proper nightmare fuel. So I'd love to bring those in. I think that'd be really cool. Really cool for a habitat. And the other thing I just had a thought whilst I was building this. I might stick some buildings over there so it looks like stuff's going on. I just had a thought whilst I was building... I used too many of these. I've decided... I had a thought whilst I was building this. I'm doing a Triceratops habitat here. What if we had... Remember that baby Triceratops mod that we played with a couple months ago? Now, I don't know if all of these are updated for 1.3 or update 2 or whatever. But if the Triceratops had some babies roaming around, it could kind of sell that, you know, it's kind of like in the original Jurassic Park. When things started to go bad, one of the ways they knew was because Grant found raptor eggs, right? And he found the little footprints and stuff. And, you know, the dinosaurs are breeding, everything's gone wrong. I think it kind of really sells that kind of vibe, essentially. The dinosaurs are... Life is finding a way, essentially. So I kind of like that idea a lot as well. But I'll leave that down to you folks at home. I know people are... Some people are iffy on it. Some people don't care. I'm happy to go with the majority, really. Let's get some water in here. We do have to build these like they actually contain... Well, I suppose this will contain dinosaurs. This water brush is gigantic. And because this is a Spinosaurus habitat, I'm going to make it wet. It's also tiny for a Spinosaurus habitat, but that's... Neither here nor there. That looks like a thonk. That's that's a bicep. Yes, bicep is the word we're going to use. Okay, cool. I really like how this looks. Like, I just like how this looks in general. I'm going to take quite a few techniques that I'm learning during this and integrate them into future parks. I'm going to try that with forests as well. I need some dinosaurs. So obviously the Spinosaurus has to pop up again later on as well. But for now, we're going to grab some trikes. And I think we're going to stick with the good old 1993 one. Come on, you. Two, I think. I don't want any more than that. It's quite a small habitat. And two would suggest a breeding pair. If we then stick the babies in the future, which, as I say, is up for debate. Get those in there, and let's get some plant life in here, make it all pretty like. Just like you folks at home. Some texture in. Again, just make it feel like I am actually building proper habitat here. Just happens to be full of death and destruction, you know? As it is. Make this one really sunny, Spinosaurus, have a little desert theme over there maybe. Just to mix things up more than anything else, I guess. Give that an entirely different sort of vibe. Maybe a little bit even with the trike. It's not really a desert creature, but... Not that any of them were, but my point is... it sells it. You know, it makes it feel different from this. So I think I'm actually going to lean in that direction more than I planned. And maybe this would have led on to like a whole desert section in the future, you know, down there past the path. But of course you'll never see it. Who knows what wonders lie beyond yonder... path. I'll do like a little palm tree display thing there. And put some trees behind there, maybe a bit of water. I really want free build water now. Like the ability to just put water under buildings and do anything I want with the water would make me very happy. There you go. Hello, lovely. I think it's kind of well suited. It looks alright. And I need some more plant life. Kind of tropical beach is the vibe. So we still need palm trees. Yeah. Oh, you would just always turn. It's because of wind, isn't it? Oh, that's kind of cool, actually. So it's bugging me then for a minute, but. Trees!
trees everywhere. Gotta sell it, folks. Gotta sell it. You gotta make it sexy, as they say, as I say. I don't even remember what it's from. And I quote it constantly. And there should still be trees down here. You know, just because we're blocked off this area doesn't mean it's not doing anything. Ah, we need a little sand over there as well. Gotta make it sexy. It's from Always Sunny in Philadelphia. That's what it's from. I remember now. You guys okay? You don't need food. You're fine on that regard. Alright, cool. God, we haven't even started on this right-hand side. Maybe we're just going to do the left-hand side today. Oh, we'll think about it. We need a rock. Everyone needs a big old rock. That's a very dangerous word to say. Just thinking about that. Desert. Sure. Bam. Everyone needs a... No, I'm not going back there again. I don't know what's changed with Freebuild. I swear I used to be able to like click in here like crazy and like stagger rocks together. It's just something we can't seem to do post-patch. Low health. Why would someone be low health? I actually don't know the answer to that. You don't need food. Dinosaurs don't starve. Oh. Okay, I fixed it. Yep. I'm sure people noticed that earlier on in the video as well, and have been yelling at me for the past god knows how long. It's to stop the children from drowning. Okay, I think I'm moderately happy with this. I know what we've ended up building today is definitely the same vibes as this, but it's different, right? It's at least a little bit different. And then next video, we head into here. Now that I've got more time, so I feel like I can change that up. Let's just do this bit. Let's experience this in first person. Remember, this will all be at night time. I'm very excited about. I've got a flashlight on. But you're not allowed to see that until the very end. One thing I really like about this as well, it's got the sound effects where it sounds like you're in Jurassic Park, you know, when they first go to the Rex habitat and they don't see anything, but you hear the birds, you hear the insects. I wonder... Can I do this? Meh. The benefit of doing this with an Xbox controller. Smoother movement, for one. But I can also slow down. Like, that's normal speed. Obviously, I can't change that on the keyboard, but on this, I can kind of... I can't turn as quickly, but... Oh, no. What has happened here? Shrug. I don't know. Anyways, we've seen this before. Sprint. Right, okay. So, next area. Okay, I like this. It already feels different. You know, all the palm trees. The thatch roof over there. Maybe we'll chuck in another thatch building. More fences. I feel very short. I feel like maybe I need some decorations like here. And this is the bathroom if need be. Well, that sure doesn't look like the way that I, as a park guest, would ever go. Let's go this way instead. I want to see the dinosaurs. I like dinosaurs. I like nondescript carnivores. And I like triceratopses. Why are these different sizes? I will never, ever, ever possibly know, but that's neither here nor there. And maybe you're walking along and you're just distracted by the beautiful triceratops. And who wouldn't be? You're walking along and you think, okay, next I'd like to see the Spinosaurus. I really like how that looks. The big fence, but then the sort of sand and the... And then the heavy forest. It's got like a really nice contrast. It reminds me of the beach in Jurassic Park, at the end of Jurassic Park 3. They go from this intense tropical forest to a beach in like a split second. I'm like, wow, cool skeleton. And skeleton's like, thank you, son. Because that's what skeletons sound like. You're like, oh, I want to carry on looking around the park. And you walk in, and then, oh, you bump into this. And you're like, wait a gosh darn minute. What's a boy to do? And you just, you know, you just can't get your way through. You start to panic a little bit, like, what's going on here? And you can just start to see the break in the fence there. What I'll do is probably break that bit eventually. But, you know, see the gap in the fence there. You see that it's a Spinosaurus habitat. You maybe get a little bit nervous. And what you start to think really more than anything is, well... How the hell do I get out? Guess I have to go this way. Bum, bum, bum! You know what I mean? And then when you open this, you're going to see just paved concrete everywhere. You're going to see tons of shipping containers and cranes, obviously, and utility buildings. And then you'll hear the compies. That's the idea. I guess. I do feel this. Maybe some fountains? Baby fountains? Do 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 do. Oh, maybe so. I prefer the plants to the fountain. I don't like any of the things with this shape. You know, this kind of stretched out oval sort of thing going on. I'm just not really a fan. I really prefer the street line ones. You can do that going like all the way along. Is that crazy? Just might be crazy enough to work. And then... You know, when you go to the bathroom, you want it to feel like a special occasion, you know? It should feel like a sort of red carpet moment. There you go. I don't know, we'll do a bit more general decoration. I will finish this bit, I promise. Because I do want the whole thing to kind of come together. But I like that we're starting to use more of the map. We needed to move. We might even go this way instead of... At the moment, we're going that way. We might go this way. Come down here, then go back up there. Because I don't think I'm going to run out of room. But, you know, we're getting in a vehicle later and going, like, proper off track. I think into, like, a safari zone kind of thing. And then maybe you have to drive through a bit of the actual park. And as someone mentioned in the comments, dinosaurs will attack vehicles. So that's a really good way to finish things off. You will actually get attacked. So, really like that idea. And, yeah. So, feel free to hit me up with ideas. I say next video we're going to work on this facility area, but since... And this always takes us so much longer than I anticipate, if I'm honest. But we'll be back this week, I promise. We'll do a compy bit in the facility area, but I'm okay to like maybe we can build the second part of the facility area as well, because this is not going to take very long. So, you know, if you imagine you're walking through here, you're navigating through not just shipping containers, because I kind of want to save that and do an Tyrannosaurus thing later on, kind of inspired by Camp Cretaceous, or inspired by that, and we'll use a Velociraptor or something else. But let's say you've walked through, you're just walking through all this utility stuff. Compies jumping around. You're not too scared. They're just compies. I know what happened to Deer to Stark, admittedly, but, you know, there was mitigating circumstances. You're walking through, you're okay. And then where does that end? What does that lead on to afterwards that we could maybe integrate? Nothing too big, but like another horror thing, maybe close contact, maybe the start of a research area, you know, and then we could start building up the research area, introduce the Indos before we start to drive later on. I don't know. Let me know what you think in the comment section down below. I'll see you lovely folks very, very soon. Cheers much as always. Bye-bye.